I got into the Ivy League, Berkeley Haas, Rice, and CMU Tepper. Here's how.
Yeah, check it. I said, what you trying to do? Yeah, what you trying to get into? Whoa. Yeah, anything at all, yeah, anything at all, yeah, anything at all.
I went to a really good public charter high school, had a lot of APs, but it was nothing that was typically a feeder for top schools in general. For all my applications, I either applied as a business major or an economics major. I come from a middle-class family in a mid-sized town in Indiana. I'm Asian and Latino, though I didn't talk about either in my essays or my college applications at all. I didn't get any legacy and didn't have any sort of special circumstances that I could write about in my college application. Anyways, let's get to the stats. So yes, I actually had a 3.7 GPA unweighted by the time that I applied to college, and that was mainly because I spent the first 2 years of my high school career trying to go pro in Fortnite. No, I did not put that in my college applications. My weighted GPA was a 4.3 by the time that I applied, and I took a total of 23 AP and IB classes. This is them here. This is my freshman year, sophomore year, junior year, and senior year. You just need course rigor. I took this stuff that's interesting to me. So in my state, we all take the SAT. I took it twice, actually. The first time I took it at school, it was free, it was digital, and so I got a 1510. I wasn't really familiar with the format. But then I took it again on pen and paper, and I got a 1570 in one sitting. And so that's what I ended up submitting. But anyways, stats are really, really boring. Let's move on to awards and recognitions. Okay, so you're probably wondering, how did I get into the colleges that I got into with having such terrible stats? That's where the extracurriculars come in. Now, they're not crazy, but these are the extracurriculars and awards that I submitted at the time that I applied to college applications, which was around the first semester of my senior year. So this is not everything that I've done. This is what I did throughout junior year, essentially. Anyways, let's move on to that. So on the Common App, you get to use 5 total honors. So I'm gonna go from the lowest all the way to the highest. The first one is National Hispanic Scholar. This was 5th. I don't know why I put it. I don't know how National Hispanic Scholar actually made it on the list. If I were to go back in time, I'd probably take it off. 4th was the UE Changemaker Challenge Top 6 finalist. This was actually a really, really cool opportunity. I had a lot of fun doing it, and I worked really hard on it. I would explain it further in detail, but essentially wasn't talked about at all in my application because we only placed in the top 6, so I didn't make too big of a deal out of it. But essentially, me and my friend wanted to create a solar panel parking lot for a local hospital, and we ended up actually meeting with the board of directors for that hospital, as well as meeting with a whole bunch of other people, like the CEO of the hospital. So that was really, really cool. I didn't talk about any of it though. 3rd on my list was the 2023 Spirit of the Y Award. It was given to one Indiana student for exemplifying YMCA core values. This was because I was a part of the Indiana Youth and Government Program. I just added this on there because it was cool that it had something that could speak to my character and some sort of award that I got for it. Number 2, I put the Coca-Cola Scholar finalist. This is actually really cool. It doesn't mean I was a Coca-Cola Scholar. I was the final 250 out of 105,000 applicants. And so I put it there because it showed that I was somebody that another committee had reviewed and chosen to be part of a very selective cohort in hopes that the schools would assume the same thing. The top one that I had was the White House Hispanic Heritage Business and Entrepreneurship Gold Award. It was really, really cool. I think there's a total of 10 people that got that specific award out of like 34,000 applicants. So I was very happy about that, as well as it also showed that I was Hispanic. And so once again, I didn't really write about it, but once again, just showed them that I was Hispanic. I probably would have done a better job of talking about my Hispanic heritage if I were to do it again. But anyways, these are all the honors that I had that weren't counting any extracurriculars. So any sort of awards that I had with extracurriculars, I put it in with the activities. So I know that a lot of you guys are now wondering, wait, so if his honors were so mid, what extracurriculars did he do? I'll show you. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing that I just did with my honors, with my extracurriculars. So I'm just gonna go from the lowest ranked to the highest. I was able to submit 10, and I used every single space, but I'll go through the ones that don't really matter that much pretty fast. At 10th place, I had alto saxophone. I did it for my school. It was for personal enjoyment mostly. I did it for 7 years. I was first chair alto in the jazz band, and I was also the first chair alto in the orchestral band, which is 2 times a week. And I also put that I play at home with my sister for fun. I thought that was just something that I could just add. It's like a little like, oh, and he does this too. But I don't think anybody cared, and I don't think it impacted any of my admissions decisions. In 9th place, I put the summer school facilitator. I actually did this for 2 summers. I don't know if I recommended it a ton, but I did a summer job where I taught 2nd and 3rd graders about math, reading, and we also did a whole bunch of little fun STEM games and activities. It was nothing insane. I did do some sort of facilitator level activities the 2nd year, but I also don't think that this in any way impacted the way that people looked at my application. The 8th one was club co-president for mock trial club. There were like roughly 50 students at this peak, so I put that. So once again, this was for junior year. So I said that we made state finals because we did it for junior year. we ended up doing it again senior year, but that didn't go in my college applications. I earned the Outstanding Attorney Award twice as well in my junior year. Once again, doesn't matter that much. It just shows, I guess, that I'm a good speaker, or at least I'm able to debate. So that's something that I might be able to catch. I just don't think any of this stuff really influenced my college application. I put that I arranged for the club to shout at the prosecutor. That was kind of true. I did. And then ended up getting vetoed by the principal because she was upset at me. So that never ended up happening, but I did arrange for it and it was networking. And it was cool. And I also put that I recruited around 20 members because as a business major, I think what's more interesting to them is seeing that I'm actually sociable and I'm able to get people to do things. Okay, now we're approaching the things that are actually interesting to my application. This one was co-founder of International Club. It was actually really, really cool. I enjoyed it. I put co-founder, though technically what happened was I was just the first officer, but I helped sort of shape what the club looked like with the person that actually founded it. And so she said that I could put co-founder, which I thought was really nice of her. The club itself was a culture sharing and community service club. Every other Monday during lunch, I would invite a ton of kids and we'd eat food from a specific country that somebody made. It was really fun. I actually got to learn a lot about cultures and I really enjoyed that general vibe. It was a lot of fun. We were basically just eating a ton of cool ethnic free food. And I actually used this club quite a few times in my essays to talk about how I helped take it from 2 members in its first meeting to somewhere like in the 60 members total, which was exciting. And that was really exhilarating. And once again, showing that I'm able to recruit people and sociable. The 6th one that I put was political field organizer for a local politician. I recruited volunteers and I arranged for a Democratic Party donor dinner and door-to-door campaign for the largest neighborhood in the county. And I said that I helped get additional 7,900 votes. I don't know how true that is because he just increased in 7,900 votes. I don't know how much of that was me, but I put it there. You know, maybe that helped, maybe it didn't. The 5th one on the list actually mattered a lot to me. It was the president of Southwestern Indiana delegation. It was for Indiana Youth and Government. The total conference had about 120 delegates, and at its peak, my delegation had around 40. I led bi-weekly meetings. I mentored a lot of kids, helping them create bill and legislature, stuff like that. And I traveled across the state to help form other delegations. And I also helped us win a $3,500 grant for the delegation as well. By the way, I promise that the interesting extracurriculars are coming soon. The 4th one that I put was being the chair of the Indiana delegation. It was 25 students per state that were allowed to go. This is the national level version of the Indiana Youth and Government. And so it was actually a really, really cool experience. What I put was that I reached plenary session, which was the final 13 out of 55,000 people that do youth and government programs across the nation. I was given a 30-minute slot to present my plan to end period poverty to roughly 800 attendees, and I also helped fundraise about $2,000 for Indiana to go. That was a really cool experience. I think I might have written about it more if I knew how much Ivy League schools wanted to see advocacy and people that are politically engaged and active, but I didn't know about it, so I didn't write about it too much. This is all I said. But it was a really cool experience. I enjoyed it. Okay, now we're getting into the interesting stuff. The 3rd one was the Innovation Ambassador of Indiana. This is a sort of unofficial title that was also kind of official. It didn't mean that I got paid or anything like that, but I was technically on ambassador duty for Indiana's innovation for like 2 years. And so what I wrote for that was that I helped Indiana create a statewide entrepreneurship curriculum. I discussed education with Governor Holcomb, and I was flown out to DC to speak to congressmen and executives. And overall, I think that was a pretty cool extracurricular that probably helped me get into some schools. And the 2nd one I really liked, and I don't think I talked enough about it and got enough recognition for it, but I was the founder and executive director for the STEM Lab volunteering program. So what I wrote was that I led 18 high school volunteers to teach STEM and tutor around 150 kids year-round. I recruited and created the daily volunteer system to bridge high school YMCA and community needs. This activity was really impactful. So for some backstory, the YMCA was given this massive building that was given to them by the Boys and Girls Club. And when I came to visit it for the first time right after acquired it, the ceilings literally had holes in the roof and it was leaking. And so there's water buckets all over the gym. It looked absolutely desolate. And that center ended up getting over like $1 million in grants to help refurbish the whole area and make it look a lot prettier and a lot more accessible to the community. So it eventually turned into the community center. And so what I did was I spearheaded the initial volunteering program that they needed. So I got a lot of really, really talented and passionate high school students to teach, tutor, and play with the kids. And so I think that what I got to do was actually very impactful there. It added a lot of vibrancy and life to the center, and I got to write about this quite a bit as well. And the final activity that I put as my number one, this one was my pinnacle activity, was that I was the co-founder and CEO of a legal tech startup. We actually called it legal tech. It was a B2B SaaS startup, and it was valued at $1.5 million. There was a total of 10 team members in that too, and so I said that I led them. The startup itself, though, was an AI-based equitable legal matching service, and so it qualified as social entrepreneurship. And that was really, really cool because I was able to talk about that a lot, especially in my interviews that a lot of people were really curious about, as well as the essays that I wrote. And one thing that I added on top of that was that I won $3,000 as a finalist, which was like the top 10 of 2,500 teams in the Innovate Within High School Pitch Competition, which is the largest in the US. Once again, this is all in junior year. In my senior year, I ended up winning the competition, as well as doing like another startup that did a lot better. But this is what I put for my college application. And so I think if I would apply like 1 year out from now, I might have gotten into more schools. But once again, it doesn't matter. I'm very happy with where I am. Overall, though, I probably wouldn't have ended up doing all the random extracurriculars that I ended up doing. If I ended up just doing the startup and I did it well, and I also did like one or two leadership positions, I think I would have gotten the exact same results that I ended up getting. So don't feel like you have to do the random list of extracurriculars that I just showed you, because honestly, that stuff doesn't matter. Engage with one or two things and engage with it really, really deeply and do a great job and get recognized for it, because engaging with activities, engaging with them deeply and having them actually impact you and shape you lets you write about them, talk about them in your essays, and talk about them in interviews. And that is actually what ends up making the most of the difference. So yes, you can have a 3.7 GPA, you can have played Fortnite constantly for the first 2 years of your high school life, you can come from a middle-class family and have absolutely no hooks to get you in, and I promise you, you can still get into the Ivy League. Don't stress it, just do what you love. But also, like, do it really, really well. Like, I'm not saying just do what you love, because, like, that's not gonna get you in the Ivy League. Do what you love, and also do it really, really well, like, at the national, international level, okay? All right, bye.